people to do that with.
Well, talking about SSG and their victory, we are going to have an interview coming up right now. It's going to be Lykan. Lykan, how are you doing tonight? I'm sure you're feeling very, very happy after that win.
Yeah, I'm good. Thank you very much.
How do you feel coming out of that? How do the guys feel?
I mean, like, this was really big for us, to be honest. When we went to Sweden, we didn't really expect to get beat by Penta, and I think we thought we had it more than we did, and they played a great game. So this whole tournament for us has been about proving to ourselves, like, that we should have already been there. So
do you want to talk a little bit about earlier in this tournament as well, where you faced 92 Dream Team? How was that for a match for you? Because that was your first matchup of the Stage 2 part. And it was a much closer game than I think other people would have predicted.
Yeah, if anyone from 92 Dream Team's watching, I've been saying this a couple times, but I don't know if they've heard me say it yet, but thank you very much. When they beat us on Consulate, it woke us up big time, and we all got our shit together, and we started working more as a team. We kind of had phases of this team, and when they did that to us, we considered ourselves back at pre-Sweden, and then we just rolled through the rest of the tournament.
Definitely. Really well played by you guys to completely roll over. You did play Orgless previously in the tournament. You did knock them down into the lower bracket. What were you expecting, and did those same expectations come to fruition when you actually played them?
Well, we weren't supposed to play them that early, but I'm not going to go on to that on stream. But it did cause us, the second time we came around, to have to like change up our bands because we didn't want to play them on the same maps. So that's what made Oregon go through. We knew they were a really good Oregon team because they were able to beat EG on Oregon. So if you can beat EG on Oregon, obviously it's really hard to deal with. We almost did it. We weren't able to make it through. So, yeah, I think where we expected this to kind of be the way it was, like it came down. If we got Oregon, that would have been really cool, but we didn't. You know, it is what it is.
What do you think about the book ban that came through on Clubhouse? Was that expected from you guys?
I don't know. I don't want to like bash it, but like basically when they banned Buck, like I can't even tell you how happy Thinking Nate was. Like I don't know. Buck's like one of those things where you have to play, but the gun sucks. And so when like you ban it, the Buck player's like, yes, let's go. So Nate was excited about it. It didn't really affect us at all, I don't think. I'm not sure why they did it, but I'm sure like they had a good reason for it.
Yeah, and you stormed through that map quite well. And going into the second map, though, Oregon, you say that you maybe weren't so confident going against them. You knew they were a good Oregon team. So then we go to our decider. Things were looking very, very good for you early on. What happened?
Well, basically, they knew, like, if they lost one more round, it was over. So it kind of felt like they just kind of said, you know, whatever happens, happens. Everyone grab an ACOG and get aggressive. Try to, like, get picks early, kind of, like, do that. And I think another part of it, honestly, is we're not used to we're having like an issue like actually clutching at the end. Like we get all the way to the end of the tournament and then we'll lose. So like we're still a young team and we have like a lot of young players that haven't gone to a lot of lands. So we're still working on like that final round, like sealing the deal. So it was probably a combination between those two things that caused it.
There was a lot of times throughout the games. I know it's something that Orgless wasn't quite doing that you guys were doing a little bit better. Adaptation, changing up your lineup, changing up your setups when things weren't working. How does that process work? Are these things that you've dry run before and people just know what to do? Is it something that you're calling out? Is it something that someone from the team is calling out? Guide us through that process.
Well, it's something that Redeemer and Bosca mostly are calling out. It's things that I call out in practice and they like learn like how I want them to play. But yeah, pretty much like my big motto for them is mix it up. I like to tell them all the time, like, even though like this is your default strat, but like once you see what they're doing, like you can completely change it into something different. So
definitely, well, that's what they just about. Yeah. All we have time for in this interview. Anything to close out this? Anything you want to say to the fans out there?
Thanks everyone for showing up and watching. Appreciate it. And yeah, we're excited by invite. Thank you very much.
Well, thank you, Lykan, and I'll see you there in person. I'm sure you guys will do great in invite. Have a good day.
All right. Thanks.
So there we have it. Space Station will take the Series 2-1 against Orgless. They will be your North American champions. What an incredible series. What an incredible play.